Hey guys, this is Aaron. I'm working on this model of a steam engine here, and I need to get some specific geometry in here. I have these two lines. These lines represent where I need rods to actually run from this section down here up into this box. These rods actually run from the middle of these two pieces right here all the way up. If I turn on X-ray, I can see where those lines terminate. So this is where my rod needs to start. I need a circle here, and I need to be able to push-pull it the direction of this line. So I actually want that rod to run the full length of this line and the original circle to be perpendicular to that line. If I was to turn on circle right now, I would be able to snap to the end of this line, no problem. What I can't do, what's difficult to do here, is to get that line, the circle perpendicular to the original line. I can toggle between my different axes. I can toggle green, red, blue. I can even try to use my inferencing line, but that doesn't really get what I want. If I just snap on my original line and draw a circle, if I was to push-pull that, you can see that would come out some weird direction. That's not going to work. I need that to run perpendicular to this line. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. And what we're going to do is we're going to temporarily change the axis so that I can draw perpendicular to this line. Rather than grab the world axis and reassign it right now, that was going to mess up my up, down, left, and right for the rest of this model. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take these two lines and I'm going to put them into a group. Important point about making a group right here, if I select one line and right click, I don't get the option of making a group. I do have to select one or more lines or surfaces and right click to make a group. So in this case, I'm going to select my two lines and I'm going to click make group. All right, so all that did was create a group separate from the rest of the model. If I double click on the group, the rest of my model disappears. I do have, if I look up at view, component edit, I do have hide rest of model turned on. So if that wasn't turned on, I'd get the grayed out version, but I actually don't need to see the rest of that, so I'm going to keep hide rest of model turned on. Now when I first enter a group, it automatically assigns the axes. It assigns the axes to the lower right corner, or left corner depending on where you're looking at it, but the lower corner of the group. If I click out, I can see my world axes for my model is down here, but in my group, it's the bottom corner of that actual container. What I'm going to do right now is grab the axis tool, and I'm going to click at the bottom of this first line to pick the first point. Now it's going to ask me to assign a direction for the red axes. I'm going to move my cursor up the line and click. Then it's going to ask me for green axes. Rather than picking a direction for the green axes, I'm just going to click again. What that does is it turns the axes so that it is parallel to that red line. So these pieces all got turned too. So right now what I can do, I can click on my circle tool. I can toggle to the red axes and draw my circle. If I push pull that, then you can see it's going right up that line all the way, and I can actually snap to the top. So if I look at that in X-ray, there's my line in the middle, and that rod is right along that line. So to do that again, I do it a second time for this line over here. Axes tool, pick on the point, move my mouse anywhere along this line. I can go up to the end if I want to make sure I snap to a point, but as long as I have that little square line, I know I'm on the edge. And I can click, and then I don't want to pick the green axis, I just want to pick a second time. That's going to put the green and blue axes perpendicular to red. Then again, I can grab circle, toggle to the red axes, draw my circle, push pull that up to the end, and I'm assured at that point, if I click out of that group, that those two rods run from the center of these pieces here up into the box. That looks perfect. At this point, I can select on this group and I can explode it. I don't need it to be separate now. I can bring that back. So by doing that, by temporarily grouping, I isolated the geometry and isolated the axes, so I didn't have to mess with the world axes or change that. So everything else is still up, down, left, and right like it was before. But I was able to draw perpendicular to those lines and push pull along those off axis lines. So that is the general idea of temporarily grouping and resetting axes while modeling. Thank you.